on from sources that Etihad Airways board will meet today to discuss the Jet Airways revival plan. Ritu Singh joins in with the details. Ritu?
That's right. Etihad Airways is a key player when it comes to the resolution of Jet Airways, and a fund infusion by Etihad will be very critical to implement the bank-led resolution plan, which has identified a funding gap of 8,500 crores. We're given to understand that Etihad will be holding a board meeting today to deliberate on what kind of fund infusion can take place, especially coming in the light of, the recent SEBI norms that have clarified that no party at all, other than lenders outside of NCLT, will get an exemption from open offer rules if they acquire more than 25% stake. Given this, and given that banks will be issued 11.4 crore shares, which will immediately change the shareholding in such a way that banks hold about 51%, Etihad 12%, and Naresh Goyal 25.5%, Etihad wants to ensure that its stake does not cross 25%, as opposed to what the lenders want, where they've been pushing Etihad to bring its stake to 45%. We understand Etihad would like to cap it at 24.5%. Also, NIIF, backed by RDR, we're given to understand, could take up about 19.5% stake in the airline if the talks go through, because Etihad will have to work with an Indian promoter as per the current FDI norms, and also lenders' own stake will come down from 51% to 32% after the rights issue is completed, and Naresh Goyal's will fall to about 20%, is what has broadly been agreed. But today's board meeting is going to be crucial because, until Naresh Goyal and Etihad pump in funds into the airline, lenders will not do so.
Absolutely, Ritu. Thanks a lot for that. Jet Airways, remember, entered the F&O ban in today's trading session, so the stock price movement affected by that as well, up 3%. Another interesting stock on our radar is CG Power, higher in trade today on the back of a spate of bad news. Anisha, the stock has halved in the last 1 year, but is the street seeing some sort of silver lining in the sort of news that came by over the weekend, or what exactly explains this bizarre move?
Oh, well, yes, the stock has been under pressure for a long time. And this morning, we woke up to 3-4 news cues, which on the first look looked negative. So let me run you through the news cues that we are watching out for when it comes to CG Power. First up, the CFO of the company has resigned, and he says they have resigned due to personal reasons. He is going to stay at the helm till 30th June 2019 to manage the succession. But nonetheless, this was seen as a bit of negative. Moving on to the second news point, which was regarding the discontinuing operation, moving to continued operation. And this is regarding all the solutions business that they have in the international geographies, which has been adding usually to the losses for the company, as well as this would mean that there'll be an additional depreciation of 200 crores that should really impact the bottom line negatively. The third news piece is regarding the invocation of the pledged shares, wherein 10.8% equity, which has been held by the likes of KKR, etc., have moved to a trust. Now, prima facie, this news looks as negative, but the reason why the stock is around 11-12% off the day's low is following. First up, a new independent director has come up on the board, and the name is N.K. Seshadri, and he is known to turn around the operations. His experience suggests that he has worked in a lot of companies and managed the financial restructuring as well as operations of the company. And now the expectation is with him coming on the board, he might be able to bring in fresh ideas that might be able to turn around the company. Secondly, as far as the discontinued operations are concerned, yes, they have been loss-making and they might add losses to the bottom line, but the expectation is that the worst is already over. And given the fact we have seen that a couple of times these stake sales for the likes of Hungary business have been postponed, a part of it was already factored in, wherein the street was expecting that the sale might not go through and the company might have to take it back. So that is already priced in. And thirdly, when it comes to the invocation of pledge, well, if you look at the shareholding, yes, 100% of the promoter holding is pledged, but around 48% is held by institutional investors. And now with the new people coming on board, the expectation is that the holding that the promoter has in terms of the voting rights will come down, and it will in fact be professionally run. And that is the key positive. Back to you guys.
Thank you very much for that. Get into a break. Up next, in a CNBC-TV18 exclusive, Brian Moynihan of Bank of America talks global growth and tariff issues with Shireen Khan. So stay tuned for that conversation. We'll be back.